What up, Styrene Slingers, Bodacious Rods and Customs, coming back at you from the Bodacious Rods and Customs Custom Garage. I am hard at work on quite a few kits right now, and I'm super glad to have that much going on my channel right now to share with you guys. I want to put a big thank you out to all my new subscribers. As of just the other day, we hit 200, and then a few more after that. So we are over 200 subscribers strong here on the Bodacious Rods and Customs channel. And I can't be more pleased to have you guys along to share the styrene journeys with us here. Anyway, to give you guys a quick rundown of some of the kits that we're working on right now. we've got the Model T, which is my Dr. Cranky build going on. And we are in the early mock-up phases on that one. So by looking at it now, you'll have no idea what's planned. But I'm going to go ahead and bring that one out for you guys just to give you a look. It's an early mock-up stage. And so, not a whole lot to look at, but this is what the 25 Model T truck looks like. 25 Model T truck. And we're going to trick it out a little bit because this is going to be a rat rod when we're all done. So, this is part of my mental process is kind of building it up stock and getting an idea what the truck is going to look like and then going from there. Another build that I'm working on is the Cobra build, and that one has been put on, not off the burner, but a little bit towards the back of the burner, because we're going to go ahead and wait on some custom parts that we're going to either use for the turbos and whatnot. And just because I like to do my due diligence and research the parts, make sure that they're authentic and reasonable. If it can't work, at least in theory, then it shouldn't be on my model. That's the way I'm looking at it. It's not because we have to hold ourselves to some sort of strict standard of authenticity, because in all reality, these cars are merely art, pieces of art, and anything goes, really, as long as you feel that it is a proper expression of what you're trying to accomplish. So that leaves it up to the artist indefinitely. So anyway, something that I'm going to show you guys that I think is fun, and something I'm not actually building right now, but I've always wanted to do, and this is what I'm going to show you really quick here, is the Cobra body on a four-wheel drive suspension. I just happen to have some parts laying around, and I wanted to go ahead and just tweak that out, just because sometimes, you know, in mock-up phase, you can build stuff. So that's just something that I was wanted to show you guys. I thought would be neat. I don't think I've ever seen anybody build one of those, so that's kind of something, you know, neat, whatever. Anyway, guys, like I said before, 200 subscribers strong here at Bodacious Rods and Customs. I'm super glad to have you guys around. We've got a ton of builds going on all at the same time. We're doing the Dr. Cranky 2016 calendar build. We're doing Chevy Truck Month. And I'm building kind of a buddy build with my buddy Jan Heyer up at Northview. We're doing a pair of Cobras that are going to be pretty neat, I think, in the long run. And one more build that I'm actually just now starting on is a Model 25 T-Bucket. Basically, because this kit comes with two different setups. So, with all the extra parts, I figured a T-Bucket would be fun to do. And so I went so far as got the color that I want to use for it, and I'm really excited on this one. This is called Courtney Orange, which is a nail polish color. I found that these Sinful colors, they're like $1.99 a piece. Two bottles of this is enough to do a pretty small vehicle with extra to spare, and I think we're going to be good. And I've already got my base color picked out for my Cobra too, so yeah, look at that, another nail polish color. This one's blingy as all get out, guys. I don't know if you guys will be able to see that on camera, but this one is super sparkly, and it's going to be a kind of a graphic noise pattern that I'm going to go for on this Cobra, because this here is going to be my my Super Cobra twin turbo. It is going to be all kinds of trick, all kinds. I've been doing a whole lot of kind of contemplating on how I'm going to deal with this thing. It's going to get the vents cut out. It's going to have turbos mounted inside. Reroute the exhaust. Run the intercoolers up along the sides of the 427 engine that this thing comes with, which is absolutely mammoth, mammoth engine. It takes up so much space inside this little tiny car. And I'm going to squeeze turbos in around it. So, yeah, hang on to your hats. This is going to be nuts. But anyway, it's fun to imagine what it would look like as a mud bogging four-wheel drive. I guess that would be kind of fun anyway. All right, guys. Well, keep at it, guys. Keep slinging that styrene. I certainly will. It's cold as all get out up here in Tennessee right now. I'm a Florida boy by nature, and so now living in the area where it actually does snow every once in a while is it's news to me. I'm not dying, but it's definitely a shock to the system when you aren't used to having to come out and watch your step so much. But anyway, guys, Bodacious Rods and Customs, just doing a quick check-in with you guys. Wanted to keep you up and thank everybody for subscribing, and I'm looking forward to showing more of these builds and a bunch more builds to come. All the best. Keep slinging that styrene. Bodacious Rods and Customs out.